On the 23rd of January 1968, a submarine from North Korea approached the US ship, the USS Pueblo. The ship then raised the US flag, and the North Koreans ordered the ship to stand down or be fired upon. Warning shots were then fired, and what happened next was a dramatic boarding of the US ship by the North Koreans. The US crew was captured, and this ship would spend up until today in the North Korean capital city of Pyongyang. So what happened? What is it doing today? And what happened with the crew?
As you can see in this animation shot, there's a North Korea's Hotel of Doom. I actually made a video on this, so if you haven't seen that, go check it out after this video. I'll leave a link in the description below.
Let's start with the USS's Pueblo's construction. The ship was first constructed in Kewaunee, Wisconsin, and was launched in 1944 during the last few phases of World War II. The ship served as a Coast Guard manned army vessel used for training civilians for the army. Back then, the ship was called the FS-344. It continued serving until 1954, when the ship was placed out of service. After over a decade of inaction, the ship would become of interest to the United States Minister of Defense, which had become very interested in having smaller, less expensive, more flexible, and responsive signals intelligence collection vessels than the other large, slow ships. FS-344 was then transferred from the Coast Guard's control to the US Navy in 1966 and was renamed the USS Pueblo. From there, she was classified as a light cargo ship. However, in reality, the ship was fitted with technology that it could use to gather intelligence on the Soviets and the North Koreans. The ship then left Puget Sound Naval Shipyard en route to San Diego in California along the border with Mexico. And the shipyard there in mid-1967. Then in September 1967, it moved to the Navy base at Yokosuka, Japan, before leaving that Navy base through the Tsushima Strait between Japan and South Korea. This occurred on January 5, 1968, en route to North Korea's coast. In the afternoon of the 22nd of January 1968, the two North Korean fishing trawlers, Rice Paddy 1 and Rice Paddy 2, passed within 30 yards of Pueblo. That day, a North Korean unit made an assassination attempt at the Blue House Executive Mansion against South Korean President Park Chung-hee, but the crew of Pueblo was not actually informed of this. According to the Americans, the following day, on the 23rd of January, Pueblo was approached by a submarine chaser and her nationality was challenged. Pueblo responded by raising the US flag. The North Korean vessel then ordered Pueblo to stand down or be fired upon. The North Korean vessels attempted to board Pueblo, but she was maneuvered to prevent this for over 2 hours. A submarine chaser then opened fire with a 57mm cannon, killing one member of the crew. The small vessels fired machine guns into Pueblo, which then signaled compliance, and its crew began destroying sensitive material. Pueblo followed the North Korean vessels as ordered, but then stopped immediately outside North Korean waters. She was again fired upon. The ship was then boarded at 8:55 p.m. Korean time by men from a torpedo boat and a submarine chaser. Crew members apparently had their hands tied and were blindfolded, beaten, and prodded with bayonets. Once Pueblo was in North Korean territorial waters, she was boarded again, this time by high-ranking North Korean officials. So that's the capture of the US ship USS Pueblo. But what happened to the crew? Well, they were put in POW camps and forced under torture and starvation to confess that they violated North Korean territorial waters while in North Korean custody. Hilariously, the US soldiers, whilst in custody, secretly gave them the finger when the North Koreans had no idea what this meant. And so when they asked, they said it meant good luck in Hawaii. What savages. Meanwhile, negotiations for the release of the crew took place at Panmunjom. Whilst this was happening, the South Koreans became enraged at not being invited to the negotiations. You see, back at the time, the South Koreans were much more hostile to the North Koreans than today, with the attempted assassination of South Korea's president by some North Korean commandos. Some even suggested sending troops to invade the North and restart the Korean War. The US quickly shut down this idea when talking with the South Koreans. So how did the negotiations go? Well, the US wasn't 100% sure exactly how the negotiations would go, but they felt it would go something like this. The North Koreans would only allow the US sailors to leave on the condition that they confessed in writing that the American sailors went into North Korean territorial waters illegally spying, and that they would promise never to sail into North Korean territorial waters ever again. Well, that's exactly what happened. Initially, the US was unwilling to give the North Koreans what they wanted. However, eventually they finally agreed to confess, and the US sailors were then driven to the border with South Korea along the so-called Bridge of No Return, and as soon as they all crossed into South Korea, the US admitted that they only agreed to write the so-called confession just to get their release. This infuriated North Korea, but now, what about the ship? Well, the ship was actually never returned. Instead, it acts as a museum ship showing how the small Korean People's Army heroically stood up to the American imperialist aggressors, and that the country could and would defeat the US if it ever tried to invade the country. Today, the USS Pueblo is in Pyongyang along the Pofong River, where it will likely remain for a very, very long time. I hope you enjoyed this video on the USS Pueblo. It's actually very interesting to research and make this video. Please like the video if you actually liked it, as it helps tell YouTube to recommend this video to others, because my channel is tiny and needs all the help it can get. And feel free to share it. And another thing, if you want more videos like these, please subscribe and give me a video idea I should make in the comments section below. Finally, if you're interested in more North Korea topics, click on the video right here to see my other video on the left on North Korea's stadium, or click here to see my video on North Korea's Hotel of Doom on the right. And as always, thank you for watching.